So today I'm going to show you the easiest way to be able to go ahead and stream in horizontal and in vertical mode at the same time utilizing Streamlabs. This way you can stream to Twitch in horizontal and maybe YouTube in vertical to be able to gain more views. So the first thing you want to do is open up Streamlabs desktop and want to make sure you have the latest version. If you don't have Streamlabs desktop, I'll put a link in the description of this video for you to go ahead and download it. It's completely free. So once you've gone and done that, on the bottom left-hand side here, we want to go ahead and get logged in. So you'll simply click on this. It'll prompt you to get logged in, and you want to go ahead and connect your YouTube account and your Twitch account. So to be able to do that, you'll come to settings. You'll come to here where it says stream, and you want to make sure you connect your YouTube account and you connect your Twitch account, because what we're going to do today is we're going to stream horizontally to Twitch and vertically to YouTube Shorts utilizing Streamlabs. So once you have those two connected, we'll go ahead and hit done. Then you'll come back here to the left-hand side, select settings, and we want to now go ahead and enable vertical streaming. We'll then come to where it says video. And here on the top right-hand side, you want to select enable dual output. So this is going to now say that we can stream in horizontal and we can stream in vertical. So we want to go ahead and set up our base canvas. So for horizontal, 1920 by 1080 is correct. And then for vertical, we want to have it at 1080 by 1920. And then everything else remains the same. So we'll go ahead and select done. And now you'll see here that we have both a horizontal and a vertical output. Now, one of the beautiful things here of Streamlabs is that you only need to set up the scenes one time and you're able to utilize them both by toggling on and off which one you want it to be visible. So let's go ahead and set up our scenes here. So on the left hand side, we're going to select the plus icon. We're going to name this starting soon, select done, and then we'll add one more scene here and we'll call this gameplay. Then we'll hit done. So now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and start adding in our overlays and our camera and our gameplay. Now for this example, I'm going to go ahead and utilize overlays from streamdesigns.com, and I'll put a link in the description of this video, and they have tons of animated overlays you can go ahead and choose from to be able to go ahead and make your stream look professional. So for this example, I'm going to go ahead and utilize the Legends overlay package, and you're going to see here this is a Apex kind of inspired theme. And you'll see here that it's going to bring everything that we need to make our stream professional, from our countdown timer to our just chatting scene to our countdown timer to everything that we need to make our stream look professional, even our starting soon. So again, you can go to streamdesigns.com to be able to go and get the package that you like, but you can use any overlays that you may want. So once you have our overlays, we'll come to starting soon, come to sources, this little plus icon. We're going to select media file, add source, and we'll name this starting soon scene. Okay, add source, and now what we'll do is to locate file. We'll hit browse, and then once you go ahead and download your overlays from Stream Designs, it's going to first come in a zip file. Super important, in order for you to use the overlays, if you're on Windows, you're going to right click and you're going to select extract, and that's going to create a folder just like this for you to be able to gain access. If you're on Mac, you'll simply double click and it'll create the folder here for you. Once you have the folder there, we'll come to where it says overlay screens, and we want to select here our starting soon, select open, and we do want this to be able to loop. We'll hit close, and you'll see here that now we have here our horizontal one and our vertical. So all we need to do now is adjust our vertical one. And what I like to do is I like to make it as big as I possibly can and put it here at the bottom to be able to go ahead and give it some style and space. So again, I like to size this up just until I have enough space. And now we have this here set up. So the next thing I want to do is that for my starting soon on my vertical, I want to actually add my countdown timer here, but not on the horizontal. So to be able to do that, I'm going to come to sources, hit this little plus icon, select media file, add source. We're going to select add new source. We're going to name this countdown timer. Add source, and then we're going to locate our file, and then we're going to go ahead and get the matching countdown timer that came with our package here. So again, you're going to download the file from Stream Designs, the countdown timer. Once you download it, it's going to go ahead and unzip it, and you'll go ahead and get the folder just like this. Now we have it, and here again, I'll be able to go ahead and live. I don't need it to loop. Now keep in mind that if you do get the package from Stream Designs, the countdown timer is so separately. Just keep that in mind. Okay, then we'll go ahead and hit close. And now you'll see here that I don't want it to show here on the horizontal. So what I can do here is I can go ahead and turn this off. And now you'll see that it's off there. And now I can go ahead and adjust this. And all I want to do is to be able to go ahead and size this and place this exactly where I need it to be. So I'm just going to fix that there. And now you can see here that now I have my timer and I have my starting soon and my starting soon here. So now this is already starting to look professional. Now let's go ahead and add in our gameplay. So to be able to do that, we'll come to our gameplay scene with this little plus icon here. And we're going to go ahead and add in our gameplay. Now, if you game directly on your computer, you're going to use display capture or window capture and select the game that you want to be displayed. If you use a capture card, you're going to want to go ahead and select video capture device, add source. We'll name this capture card, select add source. And now we want to go ahead and select our capture card. So you're going to see here that I have my gameplay. I'm going to select 1920 by 1080. I'm going to select done. And you're going to see here that now I have my gameplay added here. So now what I want to do is I want to go ahead and adjust this and bring this to a point where I can zoom it in just a bit to be able to be seen here. And now I have my gameplay here, and now I have my gameplay here on vertical. So now we want to go ahead and add in our camera. So we'll select this little plus icon. We'll come back and select video capture device, add source. We'll add a new one. We'll name this camera, add source. And now we want to select our camera here. And then we want to select 1920 by 1080. So now you see here that we have our camera. Now, one of the things that I'm going to do first is before I start to adjust it, I'm going to keep my camera at this size, because what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add my webcam overlay that came in my package from Stream Design. So I'm going to select this little plus icon. I'm going to come back to media file, add source. I'm going to say add new source. I'm going to name this webcam overlay, add source. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to locate that file, come back here to where I got my package, webcam overlay, and you have three different options. You have one with just a border, one with an option to be able to put donations and subs, and then just the bottom bar if you're utilizing a green screen. So I'm going to select this middle one. I do want it to be able to loop, and then I'm going to hit close. And now what I want to do is I want to select webcam overlay, and I just want to go ahead and size it just to the point where it covers my camera. So I'm going to just select here. And you'll just continue to size this, or we can go a little bit smaller. And then I can go ahead and adjust my camera to go ahead and fit inside of this box here. Now we're going to see here that once you set this up the first time, you'll be able to then go ahead and adjust this all at the same time together. So I'm just going to keep it there. And I'm going to say that I'm just going to bring this up just a bit, and I'll adjust it here at the bottom. And now once you have it aligned, what you want to do now is you want to click on webcam overlay, you'll right click, and then you want to select your group into folder. That's going to give me a new folder. I'm going to select done. Now that's going to go ahead and place this in a folder here. And what I want to do is I want to go ahead and open up this folder, and I want to go ahead and also drop in my camera into that folder. And now what's going to happen is when I click on folder, you're going to see here that now I can go ahead and size this together and place this exactly where I want it to be. So I'm just going to grab that there. Just going to grab this, and I'm going to place this here. I want to actually make this a little bit smaller. And let's say this is where I want this to be able to be. So now I have that there. And now I have my overlay for my camera there. And now here, I'm going to select my camera, and I'm going to adjust this to be a lot smaller. Okay, now I don't want the webcam overlay to be here on my vertical. So here's what I need to do. Webcam overlay, turn it off on vertical. And now you can see here that now I have my camera here. I have my gameplay. And now we have this all set up, right? So of course you continue to add in all your different overlays. And here at the end, I'll show you how to be able to do that. But now we're ready to kind of go live. We have our starting soon, and now we have our gameplay. So now what we need to do is we want to make sure that we have the right settings, so that way our stream looks professional. It's not laggy. And to be able to do that, you're going to come to settings, come to output, and we need to go ahead and select output mode advanced. For encoder, if you're on a Windows, you're going to select your NVIDIA encoder. If you're on a Mac, you're going to select hardware encoder. And then for the rate control, we want to do CBR. If you do not see CBR, simply select software X264 and then it'll pop up. And then you can go right back and select hardware encoder. So for the CBR here, for the bit rate, you got to keep in mind, you're pushing out two streams, one horizontal to Twitch and another one over to YouTube. So because Twitch only supports 8,000 at the maximum, you want to go ahead and select 8,000 here. Keyframe intervals, you want to select 2. And then here for the B frames, you want to leave that on. And then profile high. Now, most people say, hey, 6,000 is all Twitch can support, but you can go ahead and push it to 8,000. The question is, do you have enough internet speed to be able to support that? So the way that you know that, if you want to be able to have this at 8,000 here, you want to have at least a 20 upload to be able to support that. So the easiest way to be able to determine is to go to speedtest.net, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. And what you want to do is hit go. Then you'll see your download and your upload. You want this upload number to be at least 20. The higher it is, the better it's going to be. So once you have that there, you'll be able to determine what you're able to place here. So I'll leave this at 8,000. I'll simply select done. And now we have the right settings to be able to go ahead and stream. Now here in the bottom right, we're going to select go live. This is then going to go ahead and prompt you with a option just like this. You want to make sure that for Twitch, you have horizontal selected. And then for YouTube, you have vertical selected. Then you can go ahead and adjust your title, your description, and the actual category for Twitch. And then you want to go ahead and select confirm and go live. And then you'll be live on both Twitch and on YouTube. This works with Twitch and TikTok, or Kick and TikTok, or Kick and YouTube. You can select whichever destinations you want to be able to utilize. But if you want to make your stream look professional, and you want to be able to add all of your other overlays, like your alerts, your just chatting scene, your be right back scene, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on how to set up your overlays inside of Streamlabs. I'll see you guys in the next video.